Mr. Dika, bonjour. My name is Shamim. I come from France, and here with some Muslim friends from Abati. And my question is, what would you say to a person who doesn't believe in any religion? Or if you prefer, what would you say to his question to believe or not to believe?
What was it? Just without the mic. Without the mic.
Question is not directly relevant. However, I'll put it to the speaker to see if he's prepared to answer. Question is, what is your opinion, or what is the Islamic perspective relating to a person who does not believe in religion? Is that the gist of your question?
Not exactly. I'm here with some Muslim friends. I am not convinced in Islam. And I would like to know what you would say to a person who is not a believer when this person says to you, believe or not to believe?
Oh, yes, alright. If one is questioned by a non-believer, and the question is, what do you say about believing or not believing? What is the Islamic perspective?
You see, there is a person who, every person ought to believe. He believes in something, right or wrong. There is a type of person who say, who doesn't believe. He said, I don't believe that there is God. He says, I'm an atheist. Or the guy says, I'm an agnostic. Now, each and everyone, according to religion, whether any religion, you ought to believe. You ought to believe. If you don't believe, then you are a non-believer. You are against the laws and commandments of God. So as such, you will perish. That person who says there is no God, he is going to perish. The one who says, I don't care whether there is or there isn't, he is going to perish. Or you have the wrong concept of God, also you will be punished. According to your understanding, your capacity, your opportunities. There is a type of person who might not have heard the name Jesus. Will God question him? It's unjust, it's unfair. The lunatic, the child, will God question him? Why didn't you believe in my son, Jesus? No. Why didn't you believe in Muhammad? No. You see, each person will be judged according to his understanding, according to his opportunity, his know-how, and the message having reached him or her. So as soon as the message is delivered to you, and you can see the truth, but for some worldly reasons, maybe to please the family, please my people, please this, please that, you said, no, I will not accept the truth. In other words, the person has already been judged in that case. There is no hope for such a person. But there is a type of person who might be ignorant and had never had an opportunity. Like the South Sea Islander. Let's say he never heard about Jesus, he didn't hear about Muhammad, he didn't hear about anything. But he was leading a life according to his norm, according to his standards. God will judge him according to his standards, not according to the Bible, not according to the Quran. So every person will be judged according to his opportunity and his understanding.
Ladies and gentlemen, we unfortunately have just about a minute left of question time. All good things have to come to an end, so we can only accommodate one further question.
Mr. Didan, I have impression that my question has been misunderstood. I didn't want to challenge you or to hurt you. I just wanted to ask you for some advice for a person who doesn't believe. I just wanted to ask you for advice because I am a non-believer. I would like and I would want to believe in Islam, but I just want some advice.
Yes, sir. Do you not feel that there was sufficient advice? Did you require further advice?
Yeah, because I didn't have the impression that my question has been really understood.
So you want to know what the basics are, or what the reasons are for a person to actually believe in one God?
Which reasons? Which advice would you give to a person who is non-believer?
See, number one, we have to realize that there is a necessity for belief. If you don't believe, you can't move an inch. You can't bat an eyelid. We believe. The very fact that you believe that if you come there, stand before the mic, and when you utter the words will reach me. If you didn't believe, you wouldn't have taken that step. If you didn't believe that you will be visiting this hall and listening to a lecture, you wouldn't have come. So belief is fundamental, is basic to any move that you make. Now, without belief, believe in what? That there is a creator. Number one, that somebody made this machine. Man, woman, he made it. And that this machine is not given without instructions. Every machine carries with it instructions. Never mind how simple that mechanism is, you get instructions. Your washing machine, your hair dryer, your motor car, anything, everything, you need a book of instructions. This most complicated mechanism, the human being, created and left without instructions? He says, no, he has to be given instructions. And God Almighty, we believe that there is a creator, and this creator, through his messengers, one of us, he has been conveying those messages to us, directions, instructions to us. Whether those instructions remain in their pristine purity or not, that is something that is now debatable. But the instructions were given. And it is through those instructions alone can man find ethics, can man find morality. Without these instructions, there is no ethics and there is no morality. Man, being an animal by nature, he will behave like animals. It's only because you believe that there is a creator, and this creator said that thou shalt not marry your mother, you will not marry your sister, you will not marry your daughter. We say, we believe. You say, no, I don't believe. Then the person is nothing better than the animal. See, the dogs and pigs, the way they behave, he said, well, I behave just the same because I'm an animal also. So you have to believe. But now, what are you going to believe? Where is the source of that belief? Instructions which is not contaminated, which is not spoiled. In the origin, we say all prophets of God, all messengers of God were divinely ordained. But the messages, because they were not preserved, God sent messengers after messengers. Messengers after messengers. This is his way to rectify his creation. And in that system of sending messengers to mankind, Muhammad was the last, the culminating point in that messengership. And he left with us this book. And if you read this book with an unprejudiced mind, if you haven't got one, I can present one to you if you haven't got it. This is an English translation of that book, the Quran, with an index. Anything that you want to know about God, open G, God, more than 140 different references. That you say, I can't believe in God. So he reasons with you. This God of the Quran doesn't say, I'll fix you up and I'll twist your nose and I'll pull out. No. He says, أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. He said, how can you not believe in God? He says, كَيْفَ تَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ. So how can you not believe in Allah? وَكُنْتُمْ أَمْوَاتًا. Seeing that you were non-existent, you were dead, and he brought you into being. ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ. He will cause you to die. ثُمَّ يُحْيِيكُمْ. And he'll bring you back to life again. ثُمَّ إِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. And to him will be your return. So if you start reasoning, and you see how true the statements are, that you were non-existent. You, I, everybody, non-existent. The men of science will tell you that this earth was a molten mass. Billions of years, there was nothing on this earth, no life. The thing was all boiling. And the vapors went up and came down, and the vapors went up and came down, and over a period of millions of years, it started to cool. And then life started to germinate, and so on and so on. So there was a time when mankind was non-existent, and God brought you into being. Very true. And now you're going to die. But that is not the end. That you'll now, there is something we knew, which is other than the body, that real you, now that real you, which is the driver of this body of yours, will be made to account for your actions. It's only natural that this person, like Hitler, look, he got away with it. He incinerated 6 million Jews. On account of him, 40 million people died in the Second World War. He's just going to get us for free? If he says, no, I don't believe, and there's nothing there on the other side, that means he's free, finish. No. He will have to account for his deeds. Everyone will have to account for his or her deeds. It is a natural, sequence of our attitude and behavior. And this book explains all that. If you haven't got one, this book is yours. If you haven't got one. You got it?
Ladies and gentlemen, unfortunately, all good things have to come to an end. We're at the end of our time span, and we cannot accommodate any further questions. Whilst we'd like to return. Ladies and gentlemen.